Within the EU's precedents, there are three ways to, in principle, to continue our trading relationship with the EU after we leave. We could remain in the EU's customs union plus the EU's internal market. That would leave us a rule taker with no control over international trade policy and negligible control of domestic economic regulation across a wide field, with no control over migration from other countries in the European Union and the European Economic Area. The Chequers agreement rightly rejects this option. Or we could enter into a conventional, advanced, modern free trade agreement with zero tariffs on all sectors and including services, plus a range of supplementary agreements. This was the offer from EU Council President Tusk in March, which has been repeated recently. Without a deal, we could trade on WTO terms, which is nothing to be afraid of, but which could be less advantageous, especially for our European partners, who would suffer higher tariffs. In both deal scenarios, we should continue security cooperation, participation in programmes relating to research and innovation, culture and education. And we should deal with potentially absurd risks like any threat to uninterrupted aviation or data exchange, recognition of driving licenses, and other obvious good things in our mutual interests. To be clear, within its legal framework, the EU is capable of negotiating two kinds of deal, either the internal market plus the customs union, or a free trade agreement. The EU is offering us a free trade agreement because it is the option which meets our requirements to become a normal independent country. To be in the single dynamic and homogeneous legal area of the internal market through the European Economic Area, or EEA, would not be taking back control. It would not be a Brexit worth having. Finally, today no EEA country is in the EU's customs union, because they, together with Switzerland, which has restrictive bilateral agreements with the EU, are in EFTA, the European Free Trade Association. To be in the EEA plus the customs union would be a novel legal construct. EFTA and the EEA have been conveyors to full EU membership. Neither is suitable for us as a member state leaving. There's been a great deal of ill-informed pub chat about all this. If you want to know more about how European countries relate to each other, do have a look at this great diagram from Bloomberg, and there is a link in the description.